topic I will present is the environmental impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. Cooper provides an overview of the situation, positive and negative impacts, evidence of the state of the environment, improving air quality before the pandemic, during the blockage period and after it, how the pandemic can intensify the challenges of air pollution, how can reduce the impact of air pollution on people most vulnerable to the virus, scenarios for the relation between environmental pollution, air and virus, as well as efforts to monitor and improve the situation in all environmental parameters. COVID-19 is a global health challenge in the century we are living, with major impacts on most aspects of human activities, as well as the economy and the healthcare systems. It is already now that in connection with this pandemic have been reported and continue to be reported many loss of life and major economic downturns. Like more affected sector, the environmental sector is not lagging behind. But compared to other sectors in which the pandemic has had mainly negative impacts, in the environmental sector, the main place is occupied by positive impacts. Without hiding the factors that have contributed to the deterioration of the environmental situation. One of the main benefits to the environment as a result of the pandemic is the improvement of air quality and emissions into the atmosphere. After a long time, for the first time in the last decade, we have seen the environment calming down from the consequences of human influence. It can be estimated that throughout this pandemic, nature is sending very clear signals to humanity, clarifying that the damage and destruction of the environment has reached its climax and must be intervened to stop this process before life on Earth is destroyed, before then to be too late. However, in no way can the coronavirus pandemic be seen as a good phenomenon, but after every evil, there is something good positively affecting nature and the environment. Environmental air pollution is the leading environmental risk affecting health problems and deaths in many parts of the world. As a result of blockage, quarantine, and the closure of borders after the confirmation of the pandemic have led to a reduction in air pollution through reduced travels and productive activities. The study of the structure of air pollution or the surrounding environment is important when it comes to assessing the connection with COVID-19 and the impact that this pandemic has. Chemical characteristics of pollutions and sorts of emissions, gases that are the result of their transport or heating, are a factor in how air pollution relates to COVID-19. In the winter period, the emissions that come as a result of heating are greater, given the fact that the main source of heat for households are solid fuels, while the pollution that comes as a result of transport is present throughout the year, especially in urban areas, because vehicle movements are greater and traffic is heavier. I have some photos, but you can't see. After a blockage of activities was declared as a result of COVID-19, air quality and all other environmental parameters begin to improve, trying to restore their standards. Human during these times has interacted in a limited way with nature, favoring the latter. Reports and research in Albania and around the world show that after the outbreak of COVID-19, environmental conditions have improved, including air quality, waters of sea or rivers. Mainly in countries with large population, with heavy traffic and development population industries, thus causing an increase in the values of the air quality index. how air pollution affects on health. The main reason why the COVID-19 pandemic exacerbates the health effects of air pollution is the higher possibility of acute and chronic respiratory and pulmonary disease that comes from exposure to air pollution. Patients with other health problems, especially chronic lung and heart problems caused or exacerbated by long-term exposure to air pollution, tend to be more vulnerable to common illness and secondary ailments mentioning flu or infections. Another aspect of the analysis has to do with aerosols and the possibility they have for carrying the virus over longer distances, infecting more people. To assess in this case for the virus, it is necessary to know whether the amount transmitted from one person to another in this way is large enough to cause the disease and how deep it can penetrate into the respiratory tract. A relation between air pollution and COVID-19. Given the scientific findings, what can be seen so far has more of the character of conclusions. In many ways, the current crisis is a unique learning experiment. Displaying data analysis and knowledge about COVID-19 will gradually improve understanding of prevention methods and measures. As with the flu, outbreaks of the virus are expected during the winter, and it is possible that although the virus can spread at any time of the year, it will have lower levels during the transmission from winter to spring and higher levels during the transmission from autumn to winter. Therefore, winter weather change in air pollution, source of pollution, and the season when they are most used, as well as the economic situation of households, will be determining factors. Without effective therapeutic measures or without the vaccine, the next period can be critical in determining the medium and long-term impacts of pandemic development in our country and worldwide. The interaction and combination of factors can help to formulate measures that reduce susceptibility to this virus. Conclusion. Very important is the relation between ambient air pollution and coronavirus. Pollution that comes from heating as a result of the use of heaters is very large as a result of emissions, so it is important how will be the period of winter. If the winter is long and cold, which means that households will use more heat system, then it may lead to a hardening of the virus. This could increase the already high number of people suffering from respiratory and lung disease due to air pollution, making them even more vulnerable to COVID. Road transport can cause additional air pollution because people can choose individual transport rather than public transport due to crowds of people and social distancing. The result can be more vehicle on the road, more traffic, more pollution, more exposed from the COVID. The negative economic consequences of the pandemic can accelerate air pollution. Decreased financial opportunities mean higher unemployment and fewer source of income for households. As a result, households will limit their spending on heating from good fuels using lower quality fuels, and as a result is deteriorating air quality. In the case of a milder winter period, it brings a lighter impact of environment, air pollution, and COVID-19. Good quality fuels can reduce ambient air pollution, but since in the case the price of fuel to be used increases in contrast to the economic downturn of households, then governments will have to take measures to compensate the families financially. Recommendation. Reducing the impact of air pollution on people most vulnerable to COVID-19 through Measures to avoid exposure to air pollution, to reduce health vulnerabilities, such as distribution of high-quality face masks, filters for air purification, and their installation in educational and health institutions. To avoid a significant increase in the number of personal vehicles on the road, administrative units or municipalities can provide additional bus transport throughout the day. This would enable social distancing on public transport as well as motivate more people to use buses. Measures can be supplemented by regulating transport, restricting the circulating of private vehicles in designated traffic area, especially during peak of air pollution. If municipalities invest to have more buses, then they should invest in electric buses that do not pollute the environment, making gradual investments for air quality management. Measures should be prioritized based on their cost effectiveness, institutional feasibility and coverage of key pollution points. Reducing a highly toxic level of pollution during the winter should be a high priority. While this will not necessarily reduce COVID-19 infection, it will reduce the impact and course of the disease, especially for people with other health problems. Investments in improving the heating of apartments, as it will have the biggest impact on air pollution in winter, need the investments for more reliable data related to air pollution for the most effective measures, and in the long term run, countries need to invest more in their ability to manage air quality, from building technical and institutional capacity to institutional policies and reforms, and investing in infrastructure, especially to make heating systems more effective. That's all. Thank you for your attention.